MTI Film is both a post-production house as well as a software development company. MTI does post-production for a lot of major TV shows, episodic mostly.
Because we're a software company and we develop tools for film restoration, we do film restoration as well. I'll say the ones that are obviously famous would be Lawrence of Arabia, Bridge on the River Kwai, we did that as well.
Pretty much every major studio in Hollywood that does their own in-house dailies uses our software.
Cortex, think of it as a Swiss Army knife of post-production, not designed to replace a great color system or a great editing system like an Avid or a Premiere Pro, but it's designed to be augmenting the work that would be done in these systems in these very expensive rooms and done in a machine room environment.
Cortex is now widely used to generate an IMF package, the Interoperable Mastering Format.
The idea of IMF is to create a master from which many deliverables can be derived, whether it be foreign versioning, language versioning, different subtitles.
IMF is being used all over the industry now. Netflix has pioneered really the use of it, but it's taken over our industry. Everybody is looking to render an IMF, playback an IMF faster. You know, now we're looking at 6K and 8K media, and we've got to move that around at speed as well. Otherwise, the job just doesn't get done. We were struggling to get real-time playback with just two GPUs on these medium-sized systems that we love.
We were approached by AMD, a gentleman that I know, and he said he had some exciting technologies to show us. So I said, yeah, I'll take a look at it, and then we'll have our engineers look at it as well. And they installed the unit, and we were blown away. I mean, literally blown away.
Quite frankly, it was surprising. It was fast. It was faster than I thought it should have been. So I thought there was some trick. And the guys from AMD just sort of smiled and said, yeah, we knew that. We knew it was going to outrun your dual Xeon, which it was true.
So we would be encoding, for example, a ProRes or a DNX file at 3 and 4 frames a second. And we had hours and hours of footage. And I said, look, let's just put the Threadripper in here, just one machine, and see how it does on these shots.
Suddenly, we achieved, I don't know, 25, just over 24 frames a second. This was the magic barrier of real time. And everybody's eyes opened and said, hey, we can get this job done with this machine. And that changed the lives of everybody working overnight.
It went from 4 frames a second to 22 frames a second without thinking, literally. And that was just unbelievable. It was a eureka moment. And I said, we've got to replace all these machines, put Threadrippers in them, and let's see what the result is. And it's phenomenal.
You don't need a huge, monstrous machine to do real-time IMF work. You could use a medium-sized motherboard with Threadripper, and away you go in real time.